The delegation led by Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa toured the factory plant in Luzira and commended Uganda for facilitating development of such factories with medicines that are tailored to solve African problems.
And some of them haven't come here, but we are representing all of them. So on behalf of all of them, we would like to thank you so much, Mr. Chairman, for the tour that we have had. It has been very informative to all of us. It has been also an eye-opener of the capabilities that are there within Africa. And close to us, which is Uganda, we have learned different kinds of medications that you make here. And we are actually very happy and proud of you and the entire team of the good work that you have put into. But I would also like to recognize, like you have just said, the efforts by His Excellency General Kaguta Yoweri Museveni for allowing you to grow. And that permission for you to grow includes all the support systems that have been put in place for you to prosper here. And I believe that is a good start for you to prosper in the rest of the African countries. And I'm happy to speak on behalf of everybody here that we are actually ready to accommodate you in our African countries as well.
They committed to spreading the gospel on the work being done at Cipla Quality Chemicals to other nations so that the continent prioritizes products produced on the soil rather than importing everything.
To witness that we have been here. So thank you so much for helping us and taking into account the fact that we have been discussing about climate change and the environmental issues. So it was very good gesture for all of us to have had a chance to put a mark here at Cipla on behalf of the entire Uganda and of course on behalf of the entire planet.
Tayebwa courted his counterparts to use their positions to influence their countries to consider importing from Uganda medicines such as ARVs, anti-malaria drugs and medicines to treat diabetes, which are currently being manufactured at Cipla Quality Chemicals. Tayebwa remarked that some speakers confessed that some of the companies from where their governments procure such essential medicines are not half of Cipla Quality Chemicals in capacity. He commended the company, which he said was now both a national and continental pride.
From here, what we are urging them to do is to go to their governments and ensure that indeed all medicines produced from here shouldn't be procured from Asia, from Europe, from Africa, from America, but from Uganda. Because we also buy other things from the rest of Africa. That's why we are here. And that's a beauty and benefit of having CISPOC and conferences of this nature. The speakers were shocked at the capacity here. They were really, really mesmerizing. Some of the plants from where their counties are buying are not even half of this.
The chairman for Cipla Quality Chemicals Limited, Emmanuel Katongole, hailed Parliament for considering the plan for the speaker's visit, saying the company is able and ready to expand their export market.
This was indeed a red letter day in our business, because we've hosted over 10 African speakers of parliament. We've shown them what we do, the process of manufacturing medicines for HIV, AIDS, malaria, hepatitis, and other medicines. We currently registered in 34 African countries, and we actively trade and export to 15 African countries. We believe that the visit of the speakers will increase our export potential and ability to take the medicines to other countries. We are pre-qualified by the World Health Organization, and we are among the few companies, I think we are four on the African continent, that have got such a status.
From there, the delegation was taken on a guided tour of the parliamentary building by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, and her deputy, Thomas Tayebwa. Among addressed the various speakers and presiding officers in the chamber, where she thanked them for honoring the invitation to attend the Speaker's Summit. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.